We are live, Dolce. What do you think? Anyway, isn't she so beautiful? Anyways, Dolce here. Oh, see, she was about to shake her head again. She's going through a little bit of ear problems here. Dolce, let's show them this side. Oh, she doesn't even like to show it.
Okay.
Hold on, let me see. She's shaking her head. Let me set up the camera here so then I can use both my hands. I know, girl. So let me show you here. So this ear here was just gunky and brown and full and had a lot of this brown dead hair in there, right? Hey, what's up, Chris? So now you can actually see that it's nice and clean in there, right? I plucked, meaning, you know, pulled out the dead hair, the brown dead hair that was just filled up in there. And also, hey, what's up, Pauline? What's up, Lee? And also all the brown stuff that was in there. And then I used Zymox, got the gunk in there. So you have to shake it really good. And then I put a couple of drops in here and then massage the ear really good. And she loves it. See that? She's leaning into it and she keeps shaking, right? Oh, and so the thing is, I usually let them shake. Hey, what's up, Patty? Our favorite groomer. I usually let them shake, especially in the bathtub, you know, while I'm washing them. I usually let them shake because I don't want them thinking that I don't like the water being sprayed on me, but it's okay for me to spray water on them. So I let them shake. But when dogs have this kind of problem going on, and it's just this side is fine, and she's favoring this side. If she keeps shaking, then what happens is the tips of the ears here, because they're long ears, the tips of the ears get really full and there's like internal bleeding in there. It's like really full of blood sacs at the very tip. And it actually sometimes starts to bleed at the tips. I've seen it happen before. And so because I know she's gonna keep shaking, I wanna try to stop her from shaking too much by putting my hand on the back of her head, you know, the neck. So just kind of stop her from shaking. Or if she does shake, I'm just gonna put my hand here behind her ears so the ears don't flop around, because it's the flopping, oh, I'm sorry. It's when the ears flop around, it causes the blood, oh, see, to rush to the tips of the ears. So even if she is gonna shake, I'm just gonna hold the back of the head here so the ears don't flop around and cause the tips of the ears to get really bloodshot and full. Also, another tip, so when I spoke with Dr. St. Anji, he's the vet for Brookhaven Animal Hospital, he was telling me that when the ear it looks nasty, he was saying that he suggests plucking and cleaning it out really well. And I told him, oh, but the groomers that I worked with, that, you know, a lot of groomers suggest not plucking it because it's infected, it might make it worse. And he was saying that he believes that if it's already compromised, if the ear's already compromised, then why not give it a better environment to heal itself, right? And so, sorry, this is a face mask that I use. Anyways, I'm like choking here. Anyways, so because the ear did look infected and we can't diagnose it, groomers, what we can do, all we can do is just try to clean it really good, pluck out the hairs that are brown and nasty and, you know, preventing airflow, and get it nice and clean and oiled, right? And then after I give her a bath, during the bath, I'm gonna try to stop her from shaking her ears too much. And then after the bath, I'm gonna browse the aisles here. I'm at Petco, I'm about to give her a bath at the self-wash. So I'm gonna browse the aisles and look for something over the counter, something like Bannix. Bannix, they don't really have them in a lot of retail stores that I found, but I'm gonna look for something like Bannix where it's safe to spray in the ears, because it is, you know, mucous membrane. And so some antiseptic sprays are not safe to spray in the ears. Bannix is. So I'm gonna look for something like Bannix, something I could put in her ears that might help reduce, you know, the irritation, making her shake and everything. But here's the thing. Here's how I think that groomers can work together with their vets. Because I told the owner about this, showed it to him. He was like, oh, I did notice that she's been shaking, but they didn't know. They said they were at the vet's office about a month ago. But here's what's happening. Dr. St. Anji told me that during the springtime, during the change of weather, change of season, especially springtime, he was saying that some people get sniffles, you know, we sneeze and we get allergies. dogs, he was saying that you're never really going to see a dog sniffle and sneeze and have allergies that way. Their allergies always show up in their skin. So this could be an allergic reaction happening. It could have been caused by allergic reaction. It could be bacterial. It could be fungal. So I really recommend them take her to the vet after today's. A vet can actually take a sample and look under a microscope and determine exactly what it is. They can actually diagnose what kind of ear infection it is. Is it fungal? Is it bacterial? Is it an allergic reaction to the seasonal allergies? But around this time of year, the allergic reaction to the change of the seasons could trigger that, and then it can turn into a bacterial or fungal infection. But as a groomer, we can't diagnose it. I can't diagnose it. I don't know if it's an ear infection or not. And even if it is, I don't know what kind of ear infection it is. So that's why I suggest using something like Bannix. That's safe to use in the ears. It's both antifungal and antibacterial. So something like that, just to keep an eye on it, but also recommend they go to the vet, especially if it gets worse, because if it is an ear infection and it's not treated with antibiotics, they could lose their hearing, and it can get really complicated. But it's really just an easy problem, an easy fix. They just take it to the vet and give her whatever the vet prescribes. Let me see here. Okay. Our favorite groomer. Is it possible to be a food diet that causes the boxer to have itchy ears all the time? They are cleaned monthly. I did clean the ears and flush them when I seen the boxer. However, owner says he's still. It could be that, and also, Patty, we could con maybe consider using a little bit of oil after each cleaning, because what might be happening is that you're cleaning it so clean, squeaky clean, that it no longer has oil or the probiotic, like the good bacteria and stuff. Keeping it clean, maybe that's opening it up to possible infections or anything like that. Oil protects the skin, so it, something like maybe argan oil. I know argan oil is expensive though, especially if you're using the 100% argan oil. So avocado oil is another safe one that you could use. Emu oil is another safe one you could use. This is all you can learn from Yves Saint Bernard's skin program. This is stuff that they suggest, but you can use avocado oil, argan oil, emu oil, but just a really light layer of oil after you clean their ear. So after I get her ear nice and clean, because it's nice and squeaky clean, and we cleaned all the bacteria, zapped everything out of there. I don't want to leave it open and dry, right? So that's why if you're using hydrogen peroxide or something like that, that's going to dry the skin out, you want to use a little light layer of oil. And that way it's going to protect that ear and not so be so dry. Because once you get dry skin, that's when you get all those problems, right? The skin problems, us too. Okay, but yeah, I would suggest that for the boxer. After each cleaning, still clean the ears, but after each cleaning, use a very light layer of oil and just lightly, gently coat that skin. And that might help with the constant itching and scratching with the boxer, with most dogs. Anyways, oh, it stopped raining. Oh, thank you, girl. Okay, we're gonna make out. We're gonna make out for a few minutes. It's gonna get a little bit PG-13. You know what I'm saying? I use tongue. I only use tongue. When we kiss, that's all, that's my style, right? Oh my goodness. And she is French, right? Poodles are French, so we're about to French kiss. Right. Anyways, watch me end up with a stomach bug. Anyways, or a sty. Okay. Anyways, before, oh, see, she keeps shaking. So I want to prevent her from doing all that shaking, or at least stop the ears from flopping around. Awesome. Okay, let's do this, girl. Lee's cracking up. Patty, I was using the Pro Ear Cleaner, and yes, okay, I will try that. Thanks, June. You're welcome, Patty. Hopefully this all helps. I'm gonna get in there and give her a nice bath. Dry her up and give her a nice haircut, and then I got things to do tonight. Anyways, I'll see you guys. Ooh, cooties, boil some water. No way, no way. It's like the boy in the bubble theory, I want to expose myself to it. Okay, all right. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Ooh-wee. Good thing that was off camera. Dolores, love how poodles look at you when they are talking. Beautiful and smart. Yeah, exactly. I have that effect on women. I seem to have that. Anyway, I don't, by the way. I don't have that effect. I'll see you guys.